Let's take a look at this interesting problem on Reddit. The aim here is to create a pattern of dimples or holes on this surface, which is essentially a revolve of an arc. Can we use the emboss command? In this case, the answer is no. The emboss command cannot be performed on a face with curvature in more than one direction. You can try performing a surrogate emboss by maybe using a cone as a surrogate body. I will not be doing that here. If you are interested in a surrogate emboss workflow, you can refer to my earlier videos. For the sake of simplicity, I will first start by producing a pattern of cylindrical cuts. Later on, we will move on to making dimples. I have a circle sketch here on a plane offset from the top plane. Begin the extrude command with this profile. For extent type, select two objects and select the top face. We want to produce a cut that is offset from this top face. Set a negative offset. Set the operation to cut. You can attempt to do a staggered pattern here, but it does not really give us a look that we need. Looking at the final pattern, it is actually composed of a series of concentric rings of circular patterns. As we move away from the center, the number of instances in each ring increases. I will be creating a linear pattern first, and then produce a circular pattern for each instance along this linear pattern. Begin the rectangular pattern command. Set type to features and select the extruder cut. For directions, click on the select box and select the x-axis. Set the distance type to spacing. Adjust the quantity and distance. For compute option, select adjust. This is to ensure that the offset condition is repeated for each instance. If we perform a cross section, you can see that the side walls are normal to the sketch plane. This is the nature of extrudes. At this point, if we simply create a circular pattern of this linear pattern, it wouldn't work. We need to perform a circular pattern for each individual instance. Begin the circular pattern command. If we set type to features and attempt to select only one of the holes, you will not be able to do so. The command forces you to select the whole series. In this case, let's set type to faces instead. Select the side wall and the bottom face of the hole. For axis, select the y-axis. Adjust the quantity. Repeat this process for the rest of the holes. As you move outwards, you will need to increase the quantity. What if I need the side walls to be normal to the curved face as we move outwards? To do this, you will need to use the pattern on path command. We will start from the point when the first cut was made. Before we can apply a pattern on path, we need to create a path. Go to modify split face. Select the top face to split. Select the front plane as a splitting tool. Begin the pattern on path command. For type, select features. And select the extruded cut. For path, click on the select box and select the path. Adjust the distance and quantity. By default, the orientation is set to identical. If we use this orientation, we will get the same result as a linear pattern. To get the holes to be normal to the curved face, we need to set the orientation to path direction. From here, we can simply repeat the same process of producing a circular pattern for each instance. In order to produce dimples instead of holes, we can perform a sketch on the front plane. And sketch a circle. Align this to the origin. Adjust the depth of the cut. Make a vertical center line through the center of the circle. With this, perform a revolved cut. With this seed cut, we can perform all the previous steps that we have discussed earlier. There is an interesting new command in the form of the geometric pattern command. This command is able to directly produce a pattern that we need. Keep in mind that this is only available in the product design extension, which is a paid extension. We do not need to create a seed cut beforehand. If you have this extension, activate the plastic tab. Go to Create, Pattern, Geometric Pattern. Select the top face. For object type, select sphere. The options in this section allows you to set a minimum and maximum size of the sphere to create a variable pattern. For our case, we want all the cuts to be identical. So I will set the same size for both, and set the spread to 0. For distribution type, select circular. The radial distance specifies the proximity of the rings to each other. The distance here specifies the proximity of the spheres along each ring. We can check on the clear parameter option to ignore instances along the edge of the face. Set the operation to cut. If you look at the cross section, all dimples are normal to the curved face. So the geometric pattern command is pretty nifty in quickly creating this sort of pattern.